Hello friends, in this video lecture we are going to discuss about maximally flat low pass filter prototype of insertion loss technique. Friends, in previous lecture we have derive the equation for power loss ratio, which is also characterized by an insertion loss method. We know power loss ratio is given as PLR, it is equal to 1 plus m omega square by n omega square, where m and n are polynomial equations. Here we are going to select binomial, or it is called as a Butterworth polynomial. Then you select a Butterworth polynomial, at that time you will get a flat response throughout the passband. Right here you get flat response throughout the passband. Because of flat response, this filter is also called as maximally flat filter, or it is also called as Butterworth filter also. Here we measure the maximum flat in terms of insertion loss ratio. Means you will get insertion loss throughout the passband is a flat. A PLR, that is power loss ratio for maximally flat filter, is given as PLR, it is equal to 1 plus k square omega by omega c raised to 2n, where k is a constant, omega c represent a cutoff frequency in radian, n is a order of filter. We know that any filter has a two band, one is a pass band and second is a attenuation band. Now we are going to see the response of filter in a pass band as well as in a attenuation band. First we'll see the response in a pass band. We know pass band extends from omega equal to 0 to omega c. We know insertion loss or power loss ratio is given as 1 plus k square omega by omega c 2 raised to n. I'll do one thing, I put value of omega equal to 0. When you put omega equal to 0, then you get the value 1. When you put omega c value, omega c cancel, it becomes a 1. 1 raised to 2n is a 1, then you'll get a value of 1 plus k square. Now I plot the graph. It is PLR versus omega when you put the value omega equal to 0, you'll get PLR is a 1. When you put omega equal to omega C, then you'll get value, it is a 1 plus K square. If you draw the response from 0 to omega C, at that time you'll see that this is a variation through a postband. If you see carefully, the variation is in between 1 to 1 plus K square. This 1 plus K square value is very, very less. Meaning is that it is under the limit. It looks like just like a flat response. So because of that, due to this flat response throughout the passband, this filter is also called as maximally flat response filter. Now our aim to find the value of K in a passband. Next point is to calculate the value of constant K in a passband. The acceptable limit for insertion loss in a passband is below 3 dB. Up to 0 to 3 dB is acceptable range in a passband. So therefore, I put the value of insertion loss, it is 3 dB equal to, it is in terms of dB, because of that I write 10 log base 10 1 plus K square omega by omega C 2 raised to 2 n. Then it becomes, when you take 10 LHS side, 3 divided by 10 is a 0.3 log 1 plus K square omega by omega C raised to 2n. Antilog of 0.3 equal to 1 plus K square omega by omega C raised to 2n. 10 raised to 0.3, its value is, it is a 2 equal to 1 plus K square omega by omega C raised to n. Okay. So what happens at omega equal to omega C? K value is a 1. Therefore, write 2 equal to, I put value 2 equal to 1 plus K square at omega equal to omega C, it becomes a total value is a 1. So, right, it is at omega equal to omega C. So, right here, 2 minus 1 is a 1. K square, it is equal to 1. So, what is the value of K? K equal to 1. So, means the insertion loss varies from K equal to 1 to 2. 1 to 2. Throughout the passband, this value is very, very less, looks same as a flat flat. So because of that, it is called as a maximum flat response. Okay. Now we'll see the response in a attenuation band. When you try to draw the response in attenuation band, at that time you'll see that this is, this response increases continuously in a attenuation band. So you'll get a increasing insertion loss in a attenuation band. Keep in mind, if insertion loss increases, gives indication that attenuation also increases. So that is our requirement. In a stop band, attenuation should be increases. Okay. Now we'll see the response in a stop band. In it here, the response in a stop band. For a stop band, what is our requirement? What is the criteria in a stop band? Criteria in a stop band, that is omega should be greater than omega C. So we know PLR, it is equal to 1 plus K square omega bar omega C raised to 2m. If omega becomes a greater than omega C, obviously this value of component is greater than 1. Therefore, PLR is nearly equal to K square omega by omega C raised to 2m. If you calculate the value of PLR in a stop band, at that time you will get the attenuation rate or insertion loss rate, it is a 20 dB per decade. Meaning is that the attenuation or insertion loss increases continuously, that is 20 dB per decade. Means once again, this attenuation rate or insertion loss rate, it totally depends on the N, where N is called as a order of filter. If you want a maximum increase in a rate, so you can select the order of filter accordingly. If you want 40, then you select N equal to 2. It totally depends on the design. Okay. So once again, the main part comes on a selection of a order of filter. Now we'll see how do we calculate the order of filter. We'll see the one example, that is find order of N of low pass filter for 30 dB attenuation at omega by omega C equal to 1.2. Meaning is that at 1.2, we require a 30 dB attenuation. Then how do we get it? We'll get it by designing or a selection of order of filter. So write a solution. We know they have given attenuation, or it is called as a PLR, it is equal to 30 dB. But it has given in terms of a dB, but we require a normal scale. Therefore, write PLR, it is equal to, it is 10, 30 divided by 10. Okay. All of you are familiar with this. All right, 10 raised to 3, it is equal to 1000. We know the formula of this. PLR, it is equal to 1 plus K square omega bar omega C raised to 2n. Okay. So I put the value, it is a 1000. I put K equal to 1, then I write it is a 1 plus omega bar omega C raised to 2n. Put here K equal to 1. Then 1000 minus 1 is a 999. It is equal to omega by omega C raised to 2m. Take log on both sides. Then it becomes log raised to 999 equal to log of omega by omega C 2m. This value is a 3. Log raised to 999. This value is a 3. 3 equal to 2n log omega by omega C. What is omega by omega C? It is a 1.2. So it becomes 3 equal to 2 multiplied by log of 1.2, its value is 0.1583 N Therefore, we write N equal to 3 divided by 0.1583. It is nearly equal, it is equal to 18.94. So, N equal to, we get an integer value, that is a 90. So, meaning is that if you want a 30 dB attenuation at particularly omega omega C 1.2, then you should require order of filter should be a 90. Okay. According to the selection of order of filter or this kind of a design of filter, we will get a maximum attenuation in a stop band. So this is a response we will get in a pass band as well as in a attenuation band, or it is called as a stop band also. Thank you.